Galileo, Socrates, Einstein, Pythagoras are only the few names of the people we know to be geniuses. These names are embedded in history. We all know of their achievements and accomplishments in different fields. However, there are still people who deserve to be recognized yet weren't able to be part of a lot of history books. Welcome to The Bestest, the channel that provides you the bestest news and videos you should know about. In today's episode, we'll discuss the smartest people you have never heard of. Before we start, please make sure to like and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell to get notifications of our videos. The Bestest is all about summarizing the bestest of everything you can find on the internet. Learning more about different things is also another reason for you to watch this episode. For today, we decided to highlight all the smartest people you probably have never heard of. You may not believe it, but there are a lot of geniuses out there aside from the ones whose names will forever remain as part of history. Most of these geniuses fall victim to their personal adversaries, but some happen to have an entire society against them. And at number one, we have Benjamin Bradley. He was an American engineer and inventor. The first steam engine that was powerful enough to fuel a naval ship was Benjamin Bradley's accomplishment. Unfortunately, he became practically unknown due to being unable to patent his invention. He was born as a slave, and the law at the time considered slaves to be chattel. This meant that all their physical and intellectual accomplishments instantly belonged to their owners. It was an unfair treatment, but he did have his share of the profits. But this eventually led Benjamin Bradley to buy his own freedom. Slavery was always among the reasons why rampant and socio-political issues gradually rose. We can always sense a division between classes, especially when we're talking about accomplishments and successes. However, do you think it was fair that even the law considers the accomplishment of a slave to be the rightful property of the owner? Imagine that kind of idea being applied today. We would seriously have public unrest. But now that you've heard about Benjamin Bradley, you're probably excited just thinking about who else is on this list. Well, stay up until the end and you'll be amazed at what these people have accomplished. At number two, we have Jagadish Chandra Bose. His case is somewhat different from Benjamin Bradley. Unlike Benjamin, Jagadish could have filed for a patent, but he refused to.
No.
He was the one who discovered that galena crystals could pick up radio signals in the 1890s. However, he objected to the idea of science for the sake of profit, which was why he never had his discovery patented. He had a huge heart for science and continued in his field only to find out that radio innovator Guglielmo Marconi claimed his discovery for his own. Guglielmo Marconi was rumored to have used a Bose-designed device to receive the first transatlantic wireless signal in 1901. This was the accomplishment that managed to put the Marconi name in history books, at the same time wiping out the accomplishment of Jagadish Chandra Bose forever. Despite this, Jagadish still continued to quietly make his own advances in the field of radio, but still refused to have his discoveries patented. Well, it is a nice thought that there was one person who was more into the science of things rather than making money out of it. It was a noble move for others, but some consider it to still be stupid. Credit theft may have been something that's rampant back then or maybe until today. It also played a role in the life of our next genius. At number three, we have Ibn al-Haytham. Believe it or not, the Arab scholar invented the scientific method in the 11th century. However, Roger Bacon claimed this discovery as his own in the 13th century. This started the idea of how the West kept ignoring the previous achievements of the people in the Middle Eastern and Asian countries. But instead of being distraught in this field, Ibn al-Haytham continued to work wonders. He was also a mathematician, an astronomer, and a physicist of the Islamic Golden Age. Later on, he was revered as the father of modern optics. He may have not been credited as the one who made the scientific method possible, but he made sure not to miss a single step in his following discoveries. That somehow worked out well for him, but that doesn't mean he is someone everyone has heard of.
Who?
Meanwhile, at number 4, we have Esther Lederberg. He was the wife to molecular biologist Joshua Lederberg, who won the 1958 Nobel Prize in Physiology and Medicine. Esther had amazing accomplishments as well. She could have been the mother of microbiology, but somehow it was as if she was only living in her husband's shadow. Nonetheless, she discovered the lambda phage, a type of virus which is still being used to study how genes recombine. Aside from that, she also discovered a way to duplicate cell colonies on petri dishes. She also helped Joshua figure out how bacteria swap genes. Esther had impressive accomplishments on her own, but at that time, female scientists often worked as uncredited members of their husband's teams. Even Joshua barely acknowledged his wife's accomplishments in public. Her pioneering research was ever done in secret for a long time. We all knew that women were always overshadowed by men in different fields. However, that's not always the case. At number 5, we have Anne Bronte. Unlike Esther Lederberg, Anne Bronte could be celebrated as one of the most important literary figures of the 19th century, if it wasn't for her sisters. She was the younger sister to the popular Jane Eyre novel author Charlotte Bronte. Anne wrote a feminist novel entitled The Tenant of Wildfell Hall. It was all about the ramifications of an alcoholic, abusive relationship which was a bestseller at that time of her death. However, older sister Charlotte didn't approve of its republication. Anne would have had more 21st century fans if and only if Charlotte approved its republication rather than think of how the novel had similarities to the real-life story of their alcoholic brother. Imagine hearing the stories of these geniuses. They were among the people who didn't have the right environment nor the right connections, but still made everything in their own power happen. Did their stories inspire you to make your own mark? If so, what field do you think you could shine in? Tell us by using the comment section below after this episode. If these people wowed you, then you might find another genius to inspire you. Do you have any idea who else could be on this list? Because at number 6, we have Anna Komnene. She wouldn't be someone you'd immediately remember or recognize because she was among the people who didn't have a chance to have the spotlight on them. This Byzantine princess watched the First Crusade unfold in front of her. Her most notable work was the Alexiad. It was filled with vivid encounters of bloodshed, battles, and betrayals stretching from 1081 to 1107. The Alexiad became a primary source from the period, which also showed a detailed look into her father's threatened empire. But that's not all. Anna also included the Motley Alliance that fought together against the existential threat to Christianity. Most history buffs have never even heard of. She was relegated to relative obscurity not just for being a woman centuries ago, but also because of another historian's family feud. Another Byzantine official even wrote his own history, which contained a rumor where Anna was behind a treasonous plot to murder her own brother to have the throne for herself. Politics is already such a messy game to begin with. It comes out as no shock as to how politics turned out right now. Until today, the princess is known as a power-hungry, murderous woman. But in number 7, we have an 18th century French polymath who both had a powerful enemy and had a bad attitude called Pierre-Louis Marie de Maupertuis. He helped determine the shape of the Earth in addition to setting the stage for the theory of evolution. But again, due to his bad attitude, he often argued with his on-off best friend Voltaire. An observer noted that the pair was not made to live in the same room. This difficult friendship later burst into enmity in 1751. Voltaire sided with Maupertuis's critics, which made Pierre-Louis Moreau de Maupertuis hated him more. His principle of least action was pilloried by Voltaire. However, today it is now considered a pillar of physics. Aside from best friends, sometimes parents are the reason why some geniuses go unrecognized.
What?
Take number 8, Leonard Euler. He was someone who didn't focus on one field, just like Leonardo da Vinci. He worked in optics, astronomy, music theory, mechanics, and even in fluid dynamics. These fields helped shape some of his theories that are still being used today. Many people acknowledge his genius, but that does not include his father, who had always pushed him to follow the path of theology. However, he did meet Johann Bernoulli, who managed to convince Leonard Euler's father that theology may not be what's best for the genius. Johann became Leonard's tutor. But in 1738, he was almost blind in his right eye after a cartography work he did for the University of St. Petersburg. He developed a cataract in his left eye. Instead of being depressed, his productivity increased with the help of scribes and produced mathematical papers on a daily basis, which heightened his affinity for mathematics. But sometimes not all geniuses use their intelligence for good, some use their genius for evil. And that is what Nathan Leopold did at number 9. He was a child prodigy born in Chicago in 1904. Nathan Leopold has an IQ of 210 and even spoke his first words at 4 months. His genius was clear, but instead of choosing to use his intelligence for science, mathematics, or even business, he, along with his friend Richard Loeb, tried to commit the perfect crime. They killed a 14-year-old boy in 1924. Their failed attempt at the perfect crime inspired Alfred Hitchcock to make his film Rope. Nathan was socially inept. He snuck around with Richard since he was good-looking and popular. They were both convicted of the murder and spent 33 years in prison. Nathan died in Puerto Rico at the age of 67 in 1971. This would make you think of what he could have accomplished if he only used his genius for good. We were shocked about this genius. How about you? We have probably seen a lot of superhero movies to immediately prove the existence of evil geniuses. Do you think that there will be a genius who would want to start his plans for world domination? If that does happen, who do you think will be the genius to start making robot superheroes possible? Imagine that.
What? Bro, what are you talking about, man?
But now that we've reached almost the end of this episode, we're sure that this genius would shock you. At number 10, we have Christopher Langen. The man's IQ was 195. However, he spent his life as a bouncer in a bar. He grew up in poverty and was raised in the accomplishment of natural growth, parenting style. Christopher didn't even develop practical intelligence, which could have given him more opportunities to succeed. He lacked the support that was necessary to nurture and develop his skills. Aside from financial issues, Christopher also had a hard time dealing with people socially. He was a bit socially inadequate. We think Christopher was a genius who represented how we couldn't have it all. It is the same for all of us. There are things we cannot always excel in. Some just choose to be average, others could even be great in literature, but lack the understanding for numbers.
Okay.
It goes to show how we can all be perfect, but that doesn't mean we stop trying, right? We did mention that there is bound to be a genius who would inspire you in this episode. So who's the smart one that inspired you the most? Let us know in the comment section below. Make sure to like and subscribe to The Bestest and hit the bell to access more of our videos. Thank you so much for watching, and until our next Bestest video.